Greetings. Let's take a look at Sura 573 through 75. Musan Khan. Surely disbelievers are those who said, Allah is the third of the three. But there is no God but one God, and if they cease not from what they say, verily a painful torment will befall the disbelievers among them. So who is this talking about? Clearly, Christians, those who say God is a Trinity. 574. Will they not repent to Allah and ask His forgiveness? For Allah is oft forgiving, most merciful. Now, there are people who try and claim that Sura 575 has nothing to do with the Trinity talked about in Sura 573 and 74. We are about to prove just how foolish and illogical that claim really is. 575. The Messiah, son of Miriam, was no more than a messenger. Many were the messengers that passed away before him. Notice him is a pronoun. Who does him refer to? Him refers to the Messiah. The Messiah is called the antecedent. The pronoun is a substitute for the antecedent. So instead of saying, many were the messengers that passed away before the Messiah, you don't repeat the Messiah. You just say him. And we know, by language and by understanding, him refers to the Messiah. His mother, again, his is a pronoun. And it says his mother was a Siddiqua, meaning a woman of truth. It is his mother. His, meaning the Messiah's, mother. They both used to eat food. Again, they is a pronoun. Who are they? Well, we can look back and see that they are the Messiah and his mother. Because they means more than one, right? They both used to eat food, and here's Muhammad's best logic. As any other human being, while Allah does not eat. So what is he trying to prove? He's trying to prove here, they are not gods. They are human beings. They eat food like all human beings. Therefore, they are human beings. Then it continues, look how we make the ayat clear to them. Yet look how they are diluted away. In the last sentence, Muhammad uses two pronouns. As we have seen, pronouns require antecedents. Those who claim that Sura 575 has nothing to do with the Trinity and nothing to do with Sura 573 and 74 have only one way to read this verse. If 575 has nothing to do with 574 and 573, there are only two antecedents for the pronouns they and them, Jesus and Mary. And you absolutely must read the verse this way. Look how we make the ayat clear to them. Them has to be the Messiah and his mother. Yet look how they, the Messiah and his mother, are deluded away. Let's make it a little more clear. Look how we make the ayat clear to them, Jesus and Mary. Yet look how they, Jesus and Mary, are diluted away. See how stupid that claim really is. What claim? The claim that Sura 575 has nothing to do with the discussion of the Trinity in Sura 573 and 74. Those who try and make the claim say that Sura 5:75 is there to defend the good name of Mary, to say she is a woman of truth. But what does the one and only reading they have actually say? Yet look how they, Jesus and Mary, are deluded away. Remember, to try and dodge the obvious error in Sura 5:73-75, this is the excuse that is offered by Islam. They say Sura 5:75 has nothing to do with 5:73, 5:74, and the talk of the Trinity. But if Sura 5:75 has nothing to do with 5:73 and 5:74 and the Trinity, you cannot use 5:73 and 5:74 to define the pronouns. You have only 5:75 all by itself to provide who they and them are. And they must be Jesus and Mary. Can you now see how stupid the claim is? This really is irrefutable proof that Sura 5:75 is part of the erroneous logic of Ayat 5:73 and 5:74. So what is the logical reading of Sura 5:73-5:75? To see the answer, we must look at 5:73. Musin Khan, 5:73. Surely, disbelievers are those who said Allah is the third of the three. The only meaning which makes any sense is that they and them, highlighted in red, are the disbelievers who say Allah is the third of the three. This is what Muhammad is trying to say when he says, look at how we make the ayat clear to them. Who is them? Who are they? Yet look how they are diluted away. It is talking about the antecedents, the people, the disbelievers, who say Allah is the third of the three. Meaning Sura 5:75 is still talking about those who believe in the Trinity. There really is no intelligent way to avoid the problem this means for Islam. It means the author of the Quran thought Jesus and Mary were part of the Trinity. And that is a gross error on the part of the author, whoever that may be. Clearly 5.73 speaks about the Trinity. Clearly 5.75 is a continuation of that argument. Let's look at an example of the logic Muhammad is using in 5:73-5:75. If I say Paris, New York, and Rio are the greatest Islamic cities in Europe, how would you argue against this claim? You would use a two-prong approach. First, you would say Paris, New York, and Rio are not Islamic cities. Then you would reinforce your argument and say, New York and Rio are not even in Europe. This is compounding your logic or reinforcing it. This is exactly the logical style which Muhammad uses several times in the Quran. This is how the author of the Quran, Muhammad, thought. Read Sura 5:73-75, and in one sentence, this is Muhammad's thinking. Don't say God is in a trinity with Mary and Jesus, because Jesus and Mary ate foods, so they are not even gods. Notice the reinforcing logic. Jesus and Mary ate food, so they are not even gods. If Mary and Jesus are not even gods, as proven by them eating food, then they clearly cannot be gods in a trinity with God. Not to change topics too far, but where else do you see the logic of man applied by Muhammad? In another error, Surah 4:157, but they killed him not, nor crucified him. Again, notice the reinforcing logic. But they killed him not, and the reinforcement is, nor crucified him. Nor even crucified him. If you did not even crucify him, he could not possibly have died on the cross. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.